Antarctica, a barren, frozen wasteland, the world's most inhospitable continent, where nights last for days and the winter for centuries. No man nor beast makes this icebound desert his home, except for lonely herds of desperate penguins, huddled together to ward off the biting sub-zero winds. But wait! What are those penguins up to?
Or I guess they'd all belong dead. But Is it the case, or have we just thought in haste that they went there of their own choosing? Or could it just be, at least it seems to me, that Darwin's game they've been losing? Now picture the scene when Antarctica's green, this happened many thousand years ago. With all manner of fowl, from peacocks to owls, before all this nasty snow. Then all the birds that could fly just took to the skies and head for a warmer pasture. But our penguin friends are at their wits' ends for flying they just couldn't master. So they made the best of what they had left and learned to put up with the snow. But they never forgot all that they lost into the weather. They just become bold, and they plan for the day in their cold Avon way when they finally make their escape. So they built their own rocket with bits from their pockets and bravely set off for space.
Have to start the retro thrusters manually. Alfredo, fire thrusters!
Fire.
but one young bird, a small one called Bert, had plans and ideas of his own. And as soon as they'd landed, and just how it planned it, he set off for those mountains alone. Now his own little scheme, 'twas a childhood dream, was to ski the lunar slopes. But early on, when he was not too far gone, he despaired and near gave up hope. So he sat for a while on a moon rock pile and felt himself so alone.
'Twas then that he spied through the corner of his eye a distant twinkling gleam. So he set off at a waddle with a swig from his bottle that he packed with a dozen sardines. The sparkle grew nearer and Bert saw it clearer as a silvery box left by NASA. And although he didn't know it or cared how to show it, it was a microwave used to cook pasta. And Bert was smitten.
Is sure to end in tears. Being a Luddite since in puberty, that wakens all my fears. Her deadly rays will get their grip, I'm sure it's just begun.
Oh, I don't care, it's me and her, and we're just having fun. She's my
microwave sweetheart.
She feels much better when her shirt gets fixed.
Microwave sweetheart.
She don't say much because the settings are mixed.
Microwave sweetheart.
And we're so in love.
Everybody's right to be a little proud. We're feeling right at home in our new establishment.
Watch the TV right for me, we're
home
in place.
Trouble is, my friends, our rations didn't last so long. Everybody ate a touch too much too soon. Our kickers met their end, our mate the Wobbit sang his song.
Watch the TV beneath our feet, sleepy and slow.
It's got nutrients and calcium. There's plenty here for everyone. It's the tip of top of most of Luna cuisine.
Luna's made of cheese.
It's tasty and it's free.
Luna's made of cheese.
Forget a recipe.
Luna's made of cheese.
It's just for you and me.
Cheese? What about the tomatoes and oregano? What are you, having a laugh?
No! My mind is running over with lots of pizza topping. All around us is the smell of cheese on toast. Our fill, but show the signs of stopping.
It's such a treat, we got to eat. It's yummy and it tastes
good. It's got streaks and just like Danish poo. It's suitable for Swiss fondue. It's the tip of top of most of Luna cuisine.
Yeah.
not so far away. They're being watched by different eyes altogether.
We got rocks made of cheese. We got heavens, island, parmesan and brie. We got style. We got brains. We just hanging out here doing what we
on my knees. Sticks.